Around 2022, a Filipino renewable energy company that goes by the name of Solar Philippines immediately went on from being a no-name brand to becoming one of the most celebrated Filipino companies ever. This is because the company had reported that it secured over a 2,000-hectare land bank area. An area it acquired is situated around Nueva Ecija. What makes this so important, however, is not because they simply acquired a massive amount of land. It is because the company reported that this 2,000-hectare land bank will be used to build 3.5 gigawatts of solar power and a further 4.5 gigawatts of hours of battery storage, a feat that most people would probably never understand. What even is a gigawatt? Yet this very mega project that sits in the Philippines, when finished, will become the world's largest solar park ever. Yes, you heard that correctly. For a country located in the eastern parts of Asia, a country that is still in a developing phase is aiming to build the world's largest solar park. This, an unmatched feat that should come as a shock to most people, since the world's largest solar park is not being built in the most developed country, but rather in the Philippines. It will surpass the current largest solar park, which is located in India and is known as the Badla Solar Park, which occupies an area of about 5,700 hectares, but only has a current capacity of just around 2.2 gigawatts. Yet, India is a huge country, both in land area and population, whereas compared to the Philippines would only be a tiny portion of it. But here comes the archipelago country on its path to building a solar park farm that had far more capacity than Badla Solar Park, and a capacity that would overshadow any other solar farms around the world. For a further comparison, the largest solar park in the United States is known as the Copper Mountain Solar Facility, which only has 0.8 gigawatts of power, or 800 megawatts, or even one of China's largest solar parks ever, known as the Tengger Desert Solar Park, which has a capacity of about 1.5 gigawatts. Therefore, this newly developed plan in the Philippines will be insurmountable. But here's the thing, while it is huge enough to be the world's largest, what really matters is that it'll push the Philippines economy and energy industry to a new level. As a long-running user of international and non-renewable energy, the Philippines, after this project, will now be able to have a more adequate source of domestic and renewable energy. Once completed, it'll help ease the electricity cost burdened by the speculative nature of energy commodity prices, which has constantly been blamed by politicians and top business leaders for bringing extraordinary and unnecessary costs of electricity to the Philippines. Finally, this project alone is even going to surpass all of the solar power capacity of the Philippines, which as of around late 2022 and data according to the Department of Energy sits at only 1,491 megawatts of power. So the most important detail surrounding this project and its eventual success is the question, who is behind this project? This is a very important factor, because a lot of projects have been inaugurated in the Philippines, yet a lot of them have, as well, never been really fruitful. Some have stopped midway, some have been plagued with corruption, and some were just deemed unnecessary. So, who is behind this mega project? Let's take a look into it further. This entire mega project is handled by a private corporation that is listed on the Philippine Stock Exchange, also known as Solar Philippines. The company, however, this 2,000-hectare project is handled by a private corporation listed in the Philippine Public Stock Exchange, also known as the Solar Philippines. The company, however, is under a holding company that goes by the name of Solar Philippines Power Holdings. Through this holding company, it owns other subsidiary companies. Some are the likes of SP New Energy Corporation, the Terra Solar Philippines Incorporation, and a long list of other solar companies. Its stock, on the other hand, is listed with the ticker symbol SPNEC, which as of the time of this writing trades at around 1 to 1.2 pesos per share, valuing the private company at 12 billion pesos. A pretty small valuation for a company aiming to revolutionize the entire Philippine energy industry. For comparison, companies such as Ayala Corporation are valued at over 427 billion pesos. But anyway, Solar Philippines' operations, as reported by its investor report, are also pursuing other solar projects across the Philippines, and even some outside of the country. Denoted as SP Batangas Baseload is a 1.8 gigawatt project expected to have a non-land capital expenditure of about $1.5 billion to the Bali project in Indonesia, and a long list of other solar projects. Most of their projects are occasionally contracted with overseas and major Filipino companies. Its Batangas 1 project, for instance, is partnered with South Korean firm KEPCO, whereas the Tarlac 2 project is partnered with Aken Energy, an Ayala Corporation firm, among others. Going back to the 3.5 gigawatt project that is stated to become the world's largest, this small project, yes, we mention it as small because it is just one part of the mega plan of Solar Philippines. You see, Solar Philippines has a bold target to construct over 10 gigawatts of power projects. This is, therefore, almost thrice more than the so-called upcoming world's largest solar park. A huge feat that Solar Philippines estimates will cost approximately $7 billion of non-land capital expenditure. All in all, would surmount to have a potential revenue of about 61 billion pesos or more than $1 billion per year. The cost baseline, as projected by the company, is about 4.36 pesos per kilowatt hour, which is far less than the current household price of electricity as reported by globalpetrolprices.com at 9.7 pesos per kilowatt hour. The entity established to undertake the project is known as Terra Solar Philippines, a partnership between Solar Philippines and Prime Infrastructure Capital, a company held by the Filipino billionaire Enrique K. Rayzon, who is also famous for his other companies such as International Container Terminal Services, one of the world's largest global port management companies, and Bloomberry Resorts Corporation, the owner of big entertainment buildings situated in both the Philippines and South Korea. These two companies have then established Terra Solar Philippines, with a 49.9% ownership stake going to Solar Philippines and a 50.1% stake to Prime Infrastructures. The 2,000-hectare project's non-land capital expenditure is estimated to be $3.2 billion and is slated to generate around 28 billion pesos, or more than half a billion dollars in annual sales every year. The project's timeline is slated for commercial operation by 2025, an immediate start considering that it is just a few years away. The exact details of this project, however, are still unfound. Terra Solar is expecting between 2.5 to 3.5 gigawatts of power and 4 to 4.5 gigawatts of batteries. Therefore, as the company enters into this stage of development, the output could vary between the projections and a possible change from the initial projections. The only question that we would arguably raise is the exceedingly initial cost of the project. While we can justify whether this is the right or even the best option for the Philippines right now, we can, however, say that as this is a project connected to a private corporation, it is, therefore, aimed to make a profit. On the note of being a private entity, we can also suggest that, unlike other mega projects in the Philippines, at the very least, this will have zero, or hopefully little, to do with politicians. But the most important question raised for the partnership of these two major conglomerates is, where are they actually going to get $3.5 billion for non-land capital expenditure alone? $3.5 billion, after all, is a massive amount of money. Even Enrique Rayzon, a Filipino billionaire who stands as the second richest man in the Philippines, is worth around $6.4 billion, according to Forbes. Does this suggest that he is going to finance all of these by himself? Well, it is not stated who is going to actually finance the project. What is stated, however, is that it is almost a 50-50 project between Solar Philippines and Prime Infrastructures, which can suggest that the cost may also be divided between the two. Solar Philippines, however, may also seem to be cash-ready. The company itself recently listed its stock on the public stock exchange around late 2021, which helped the company raise about 1.3 billion pesos. A further stock rights offering raised around late 2022 was also followed, which helped the company raise yet another 2.8 billion pesos. And finally, as of the latest quarterly report, the company has about 6.1 billion pesos in total assets, 3.5 billion pesos of which are current assets. Plus, it is also possible that the project can be taken out as a loan. But anyway, as we are unsure where the total money is actually going to be taken from, or probably another fundraising scheme sometime in the future, do still let us know what you think about this project, and even if you know where they are going to take the money from. Thanks for watching.